The biggest change in my life today, like everyone would want to hear, is I'm getting married. And this man is called Francis Atwoli. I know people have talked about it so much, and there's a surprise, people are shocked, they're like, how? This is one man I knew back in 2005 when I was in Uganda. He came for an interview in UBC, and being a guy from home, I didn't know who he was. You know how you just get, whenever we meet people from Kenya, we'll be so excited. Oh, there's someone who's come from Kenya, come and say hello. So I came and said hello, and we just got in touch. So when I came back to Kenya in 2011, we would get, maybe we'll talk like once even in a year. Like, just, how are you? I'm doing very well, and that's it. So when I came back to Kenya, I called him and told him, oh, by the way, I'm back in Kenya. And then I went to see him, saw him. And then we've been in touch for a very long time. And then we would go separate ways, he does the things, but we're very in touch. He's a very close family friend. So he will come home whenever he's home and he's coming to Bungoma to do anything. And then me, I was in a relationship with this person I thought I wanted to get married to. So when I changed my mind with that person, and then he had someone else in his life and they fell apart. And then he was like, I need someone in my life, Mary. I can't live alone. Because he has a wife who's home. Then he's like, Mary, I can't live in Nairobi alone. And, you know, I'm growing older, my wife a little older. And then I just need help, you know. And then because we are very good friends, that's one thing. Anyone who has been close to us would know that Mary and this guy are very inseparable. The shock that we've given them is that we're getting married. That's something they never expected. Even me, before, when he told me, because he said, Mary, I don't want to be your boyfriend or anything that is not marriage. If you're not ready, it's okay. But if you get ready and you feel like you're ready, let me know. Of course, I was not bothered at that time. Then I reached a point, I'm like, I've dated young people. And like, I've just talked about one that I regret so much. And I felt like he treated me so well. He respects me, because we respect each other. And then he shows me genuine love. If people doubt that is love, people who have hung around me believe that is love. And he loves me. And being his status, some people would be like, oh, it's his money. I refused to be with him on several occasions before, but I knew when I came to Kenya, that's when I realized, oh, this guy is rich. As in Uganda, I didn't know, but we're still very good friends. So some people be like, oh, it's about his money. It's not about his money. I've met people with money before, and I know some people who have a lot of money don't respect people because they think the money speaks for them and the money can get them anyone they want. Him, he knows it's not his money, because even when he had money before, I told him no. So he knows it is not his money, and even me, it's not about his money. Money is, of course, an added advantage. No one wants to live a life that is, you're not sure about your future. It is always very nice when you know that your future is secured. That one, if I said it's not, if we totally leave out the money factor, then we will be lying. All of us are working because we're looking for money to secure our future. So it is just an added advantage that the comfort comes with the love. So much has changed. I'm not able to catch up with my friends that I used to. You don't just wake up and go to a place. Like, I love going to the US every August. Now this time it says you're not going anywhere. You know, you need to realize that your life has changed, not just the way you used to do. Oh, in July I used to go to Europe, so I have to go in August. There's nothing like that. So you sit and agree. There are a few times you say, no, you can't go here. And then just to make me realize, because we keep saying, when you find someone who is, I'm 34, I've been living alone for 34 years, that things are just used to doing their way. So it's not easy to change them. So he keeps reminding me, you just have to adjust a little bit. There are things I want to do on my own, and I realize that I have help around me. I need just to sit and enjoy. But I'm used to running around and doing all these things, and then there are people who are always there at me, madam, how are you? How can I help you? This breakfast, what do you want to have? I was not used to that kind of a life. And then a few times someone will chauffeur you. I'm used to, and I still enjoy driving myself. But when I want to stick to that, I just want to just enjoy doing that. So much has changed.